Kumusta mga kababayan? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, the show for the Filipino community. Your host today, Marky Mark, and here we are with JR on my side.
What's up, guys?
And we got these guys back because they were so good from last episode. Yeah, Bruno, how you feeling?
I'm good. I'm ready to watch DeRozan get his first All-Star MVP in his hometown of LA.
Ooh, big stand, well, man.
Coming in hot, Okay.
And we got Xander back again. How you feeling?
I'll make another DeRozan. Oh, yeah? He's going to the dunk contest. He's going back.
These guys have so much aspiration for the Raptors. I told you guys, they're big Raptors fans. But don't you worry, we're going to have these guys on the game floor today. And we're going to play the game called Pinoy Crossover Show. And we're going to have them answer some questions. So stay tuned. Welcome to Pinoy Showdown. Here we got Bruno on this side, on the left, right side. And we got Xander on the other side, facing it off, one-on-one, just between them. Are you guys ready?
Ready to roll.
Always ready to rock.
All right, we're gonna keep the all-star team for this week. So we're gonna ask these guys some all-star questions and they're gonna have to answer and defend why they chose that player or whatever it is that they choose. Are you guys ready? Mm-hmm. All right, first question, guys.
Let me just flip this.
Which player would you like to see win the slam dunk competition?
Ooh.
When I count to three, you guys are gonna say it, and then I'm gonna choose which side to defend. Are you guys ready? 3, 2, 1.
Donovan Mitchell.
Jr.
Ooh, so why Donovan Mitchell?
Have you watched his games? I don't even know if I need a defense. Have you seen his games? Okay. He's a 6'3" guard, 6'4". Everyone loves the low guys, right? Dan Smith's also a low guy, but he has the same dunks. Donovan Mitchell, like his dunks, like he's scary when he dunks it. He's like a young Dwayne Wade. Big hands, long arms, always just looks good when he dunks it. Like, you know what I mean? Like, he has that look when you dunk it, you just like want like, ooh. Like, you want that on a jersey. You want that on like a logo. Something about him just more exciting than Dan Smith, because Dan Smith, he does the Damian Lillard.
Damian Lillard's pretty exciting. He does that. He has those Westbrook dunks where he comes in, he crams him, he's small point guard, he's coming in hot.
Not the same as Westbrook.
No, he's got that fierceness. He's got the fierceness.
I'll let you go, I'm sorry.
All right, maybe not the level of Westbrook, because he's one of the angriest dunkers of all time. But Smith has some angry dunks. He's a showman. Like Donovan Mitchell, he's got a little bit more of that little guy effect. We all remember how the Nate Robinson versus, was it DeRozan, Dwight Howard, all those years.
Oh, everyone.
The little man always, it just looks so much more spectacular for some reason. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to go with Dennis Smith Jr. He's a bit more of a showman, and he's been my guy since college, so going with him.
All right, next question. Which player would you like to see win the three-point competition? Mm. 3, 2, 1.
Jonas Valanciunas.
Wow. I was gonna say Steph Curry. He's not gonna be in it, but Steph Curry, not last year, but 2 years before, Steph Curry, Klay Thompson going up against each other was awesome. It was the two of the best three-point shooters in the league.
It awesome though?
Yeah. It was awesome. It was cool. It was cool. The Splash Brothers. They should just not let anybody else in and just do the all Warriors three-point guard. Warriors and Rockets.
Zaza?
Yeah, I want Zaza in there. You put Valanciunas. Does he have like 3 minutes to do all 30 shots?
Well, I mean, I was going to get to that.
Yeah.
Where is this guy? Okay, you can try to defend yourself, YJV.
Oh, he's not going to be in the competition, but if he did go, I'd want him to win.
Yeah.
Here's why.
Why?
Just because Jonas Valanciunas. A big man shooting threes and ridiculously slow. It's something you've never seen in the three-point competition before. That's it.
I do agree with you where I'm almost ready to do something new in the three-point competition.
Like a big man three-point competition.
Yeah. A big man or do like a two-on-two, like do team-wise. So like two Warriors, two Rockets, two Celtics, two Cavs.
Because we've had
like
big men before, but no one who shoots so slowly and always wants to hold it and pump fake like Jonas. It'd be honestly a very different kind of entertaining three-point contest with him.
Yeah, something almost a little bit needs to change. Just get a little bit of fatigue. Mm-hmm. But
E versus West, maybe before.
Do something. Yeah. But although they've tried to mess around with the dunk contest, and it's looked absolutely terrible sometimes.
I hate it.
So classic way, sometimes the best way. Yeah.
How about who would win the All-Star MVP?
Ooh.
I'm going to go off script here. Who would win the All-Star MVP? You guys ready? Mm. 3, 2, 1.
DeMar DeRozan!
I can't help it. This guy's in a Raptor.
He's in his hometown of LA. He's having the best year of his career. He's ready to hashtag prove him. That's his thing. He's going to do it this year. He's a starter. He's feeling good. He wants to show the whole league that the Raptors are serious this year. And he's going to be doing it against Dwayne Casey, his coach, who maybe is going to let him, you know, slide through. He's going to put him on against some favorable matchups. You know?
He's the Comp 10 kid. And if James Harden doesn't come, you know, he's really the only LA guy that'll be there. So he's going to be the hometown guy regardless. And if James Harden's not there again, like, he's the number one guy they can root for. So I think he has a luck. He has a better chance than he's ever had before.
Yeah, I agree. I think he's going to put on a great show this year. And he's got Lowry on his team, which is nice. Mm. So he'll be feeding him. You know, Lowry wants to get DeMar the All-Star MVP just as much as DeMar wants it himself.
Exactly.
So for the last question, another off-script. Since we all talked about three-point dunk and the All-Star, what would be the highlight, the best highlight of the whole All-Star weekend? Is it one of the three or something else? Mm. Are you guys ready? 3, 2, 1.
LeVar Ball.
All-Star game. That's awesome. I hope it is LeVar Ball.
Okay, this comes out of nowhere.
I hope it is LeVar Ball.
I always like the off.
What makes you think the All-Star game will be just the highlight?
You know what? I think the guys are really going to come together and play this year. Like, it's often been very relaxed. They seem to blame the format the last few years. It has nothing to do with that. It has the fact that they're tired after a long weekend and they're not playing. They just got to play. And I think it feels a little bit different this year. Maybe the fact that they're actually playing with their team logo on the front means a little something, something. I don't know. They're playing, some of them are playing against teammates. I don't know. I feel like this year's got a different year. Maybe also, just to keep going really quick, it's in LA. There's going to be a lot of celebrities there. Professional athletes like to show off in front of other celebrities. It's going to be some big parties. You want to go home with that trophy. You want to go home with the win.
With Lonzo Ball being in the skills competition, LeVar's already planned his trip. He's already planned exactly what he's going to do each day. He's going to crash the TNT crew, the ESPN crew. He's going to be on all those talk shows. It's going to be awful, but entertaining as
entertaining
hell, as
for
all
sure.
Hell.
They should do an all-dad skills competition.
Oh, my God.
LeVar. Who else is it?
Curry.
Tim Hardaway.
It could take Del Curry.
Del Curry. Yeah,
would Michael Jordan count?
He doesn't have any sons.
Not the NBA,
Thompson. Michael Thompson. There's another one. I don't know anybody else.
Well, not Luke Walton anymore.
We already got a few in there.
Bill Walton.
Yeah, there it is.
But LeVar Ball, he's going to do something stupid and crazy. He may even, like, coming Doc Rivers, right? He may even come in on the All-Star game and try and play. He may be like, whoa, we need to bring in Lonzo Ball. So,
I think they should take a script from the WWE and have a special guest referee for the All-Star game.
Bring in LeVar Ball.
Has his own theme music and everything. Run down like he did in the WWE.
Hit somebody with a chair.
Did you see him? He was actually on WWE.
Yeah, he was fantastic.
That's all we have for Pinoy Crossover Showdown. Guys, fans out there, vote who had the best answer for all the All-Star questions that I've asked for them.
Jonas.